Hello guys, welcome back to our channel. This is day 6 of MIT App Inventor series. So let's start this project. Click on start new project and say day 6 app. That's our app here. So in the left side, you will find we already have learned about button, checkbox, state picker, image, label, list picker and list view. Now we're going to learn about notifier here first. So let's drag and drop notifier here. What is the use of notifier? So you can use that notifier to display the notification, to display the error, to display a lot of things. Okay. So what I will do here, I will use your one button. Okay. One. And once the people click on that button. Okay. So, or I can say like, I will submit one data. Okay. I will not submit that data anywhere, but suppose I have one form like this. I will make all this thing in a center like this. So suppose I have one form. Okay. There's text field. And once I click on that button, so I will use here that submit button. Okay, once the people submit the data, so we have to display the notification what you have submitted. Okay, so how we can do this? We have notifier here. Now go to the block, and once the people click on button, click this one. So click on notifier, and as you can see here, there are a lot of things. Okay, so when the notifier choosing, after text input, there are a lot of things. So what do we need to do? We need to display here some message. So what can what I can do here, I can show alert. Okay, this is the show alert, but I will use your dialog box, this one, show message dialog. So I will just use this here, and in the message, what I'll say here, I will display your input. Okay, and in the title, I just say your input. Okay, and in the message, I will display the input. So input is text box 1.txt here, and button is, I will use here one button is called okay. Like this, and say okay. Okay, now let's go to the design. Let's run this app. I'm using an emulator. As you can see, that's the text box. So let's put some information here. Suppose this is my submitted data. Okay, like this. So what I will do here, I'll just click on submit button. And as you can see, your input, submitted data, right? And okay, it's gone. So that is the use of notifier. You can notify that using timer also. You can use one timer. After some seconds, you can display that notification. And there are a lot of options how we can display the notification. As you can see, there is one alert box. Okay, you don't need to click on anywhere to show this. Okay, to this will display for only few seconds. Okay, so what I will do, so alert your input or something, I'll just say the text box value. And I will delete this one. Okay, and let's see how this will work after button click. Okay, so just put something hello and let's click on submit. As you can see, hello, there is hello one, right? So this is the alert, something like this. So there are a lot of way to use notifier. There are a lot of information, like you can use dialog box. You know, you can use conditions here also. Like once you use the choose dialog, you can use the condition based on the user input. Okay, as you can see, after choosing, this is the choice. There are a lot of option to use notifier. Okay, so now let's go to the design and let's focus on another. So this is the password text box. So this is just for whenever you want to use password for a user. Okay, whenever you want to use password and you want to get a password from the user. Okay, so you should use that password field. This will automatically hide your value. Okay, so that's the password field here. Let's click on connect, refresh this. Let's see that password field. See, second is password field. So let's put the username, suppose. So username is Saurabh and the password is, suppose, Saurabh. As you can see, hide is there. This is, it look like password. It's look like password, right? So that's the use of password field. Okay. Now, as you can see, a slider. So what is the use of slider? So let's drag and drop this here. So I'll show you how we can use that slider. Okay, so let's here, as you can see, I can't see nothing here. Like see this one. So go to here and you can see here the max value is 50. So what I will do, I will use your max value 100 and minimum value is 10. Okay, and thumb position is also 10. Cool. Now what I will do, I'll just make this width is percent is 90 and okay. Right. And let's go here and see. This is like this. So see, you can drag like this. So now what I will do here, on dragging, okay, on this dragging, I need to change the value. So you can use this this component to increase the volume, increase the brightness, this component in many ways. So let's how we can get this. So what I will do, I will just use here one label and I will increase the value. Okay, this is 0 suppose, and just 30 like this. Okay, I will increase that value on that increasing of that slider. Okay, value. Let's go to the block, click on slider. As you can see, position changed. Okay, thumb position like this. Okay, so what we need to do here, let's click on that label and set label dot text here, and we just need to get the thumb position. Just click on this and get thumb position like this. So let's refresh this and let's go here and let's do this. See, you're getting the thumb position here. Cool. So that's the use of thumb. Okay, now let's go to the design. Left side you'll find a spinner. So what is the use of a spinner? So a spinner component is display pop up with a list of element. Okay, and this element can be set in the designer or the block editor by setting. Okay, so let's drag and drop this spinner here like this. And now if you want to add item, as you can see, this is the drop down list, and as you can see, the element is string. So suppose book 1, book 2, and book 3 like this. Let's go here, and as you can see, this is the drop down list. See, book 1, book 2, book 3 like this. So that is the use of that spinner. Okay, so tomorrow we will learn how we can use the switch, then text box and time picker and web view. Okay, so web view is the really most important thing. Okay, because using this web view, you can create app of any website. You can convert any website to the app using web view. Okay, so that's the really very important topic. Just comment on the video. I'll try my best to solve the problem. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel, like this video and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye.